Hello everybody, welcome back to another tutorial video. Today we will be tackling 2D projectiles in Unity. I hope you're doing well. Strap up, we're diving right in. Alright, we'll be using the same world setup as in the previous tutorial. As with our other tutorials, all assets used are free. The only asset we'll be adding today is the nice little magic blue fire sprite. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. First up, we'll set up the prefab for the projectile. Let's simply drag that into the scene view. Wow, that's huge. We can adjust the scale of the object directly. That's much better. The sprite is still pointing down, so let's rotate that to point forward. That looks great. One important thing to keep in mind is that when we spawn the projectile, we want it to point in the direction the character is facing. This means we need to set the rotation when we spawn it. The trouble is that that will override the negative 90 degrees Z axis we just set. There are two ways in which we can fix this. The first would be to set the negative 90 degree rotation every time we spawn the projectile. This gets complicated really fast when we have other projectiles that do not need this. The second, which we will be doing, is to nest the sprite inside a parent game object, which may then have the default rotation when spawned, which is much, much easier. Next, we need a collider so we can detect when a collision occurs. And finally, we need a 2D rigid body with a Y position constraint set to freeze. That's all for the visual aspect. Let's create a new script called Projectile Behavior. And open it. And, as always, we clean it up. The only thing the projectile needs to do in this tutorial is move forward and destroy itself when it hits something. For this, we need a single float variable called speed. Let's make it move 3 times as fast as the player. Great. Now let's make it move forward during the update method. Since the character and projectile's orientation is left by default, let's use negative transform.right, multiplied by time.deltaTime, and then multiplied by our speed variable. The projectile script needs to do one more thing. It needs to destroy itself when a collision occurs. For that, we can use the onCollisionEnter2D method, which, as you can imagine, is triggered when a collision occurs. Take note, since we are using 2D colliders, we have to use the onCollisionEnter2D method and not the onCollisionEnter method, which is for 3D applications. This is a common mistake which is quite hard to spot later on. When this method triggers, all we need to do is call destroy and pass along the game object of this projectile. That will destroy the object. That's it for the projectile script. The next thing we need to do is set up the character 2D controller. The only thing we need to do here is spawn the projectile when we press the fire button. For this, we are going to need two variables. One for the projectile prefab, and a second for the launch offset. We are going to make this a transform. Finally, in the update method, we are going to check the input for when the fire button is pressed. Then, we are going to instantiate the projectile prefab at our launch offset position, facing in the character's forward direction. Let's head back to Unity. We can now add our projectile behavior script to our projectile and drag it down to the asset window so it becomes a prefab. Then we need to delete the instance we currently have. Next, we should create the offset from where the projectile will fire. Typically the tip of a weapon, or in our case, in front of the player. There are two more steps left. We need to set the projectile prefab on the character 2D controller and the offset transform. Then we can put the whole thing to the test. Let's hit play. And click, click, click. Ah, sweet. Isn't it pretty? There's only one problem, and that's that these bolts travel forever. Let's create a simple obstacle. With a collider. And hit play again. The projectiles now hit the obstacle and destroy themselves. And done! In less than 5 minutes, you now know how to implement 2D projectiles in Unity. Head over to Patreon to see how you can suggest new videos and vote on our new content. We'll leave a link in the description below. And don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and notification buttons to stay up to date with our 5-minute tutorial series. Let us know what you think about this video in the comments below. Further, we're happy to answer any questions you may have about Unity on our Discord. And that's a wrap. See you in the next one. We'll probably end up doing an audio video next. Subscribe for more content like this.